because MCC started during the presidency of President Nkrumah. And, you know, even though they never, you know, propagate this thing about the MCC, the way where the SLPP make this MCC whole thing. But let me show you guys a video of President Nkrumah talking about the MCC, the advent of the MCC coming into Sierra Leone. Let me show you guys that video so you guys would see what I'm talking about.
Well, partnership with the U.S. government is clearly an indication of the progress we have made as a country, considering where we are coming from. We have made progress in terms of improving on governance, deepening democracy, improving the quality of lives of our people, creating an environment for investment, and resulting from this progress, MCC have engage with us, and this engagement will require us to stay focused on improving on the issues of good government, providing improving on the lives of our people, and ensuring that we remain focused, because the MCC is there to help you, but you must remain focused on the issues that you will do that will provide a great benefit to our people, and together you move on the path of transforming the country.
All right, so guys, as you guys can see, Leonasia, Millennium Challenge Corporation, United States, right? That was President Nkrumah with the MCC. That's how they started. They get a $44 million threshold where they be used to implement water systems them across the country. Where if you go to like today, you're gonna Kailahun, then place today where President Nkrumah give them water. You know, there's some of those villages, then town, and they never ever had water. They don't get water. The people in the suffer, they drink dirty water. The SLPP has never provided water for the Nkrumah. But President Nkrumah did that for them. You know, guys, so this is why we are showing you guys this thing, so you guys would understand. Let us know exactly where we're coming from. But let's go back to the MCC. And let me share, you know, the website of the MCC with you guys. I don't show that it's scorecard. I want you guys to see these things. You know, so we all go learn as Sierra Leoneans them, and we go know how to tackle these issues. We cannot be preaching one thing, but then the reality is otherwise. That means we are deceitful, we are liars, and we cannot continue to lie to the international community. Because if anything, which man care about, not incredibility. So we cannot allow the SLPP to lie about the reality. Now, let me show you again what is about political rights and civil liberties. So when I point out and show una the MCC scorecard, that relate them to real life situations. I want you guys to see. This is the MCC scorecard for Sierra Leone in 2021, actually. This is it right here. 96% in political rights. Civil liberties, 94%. But when I tell me about Sierra Leoneans, them, when I evaluate this for me, should I be the only one where they see what they see now? I know you guys see these things. How is this government scoring 90% in the 90% range with this? So let me do one thing. I want to compare Sierra Leone in political rights and civil liberties. Let us compare that with like a Rwanda. I'm going to go back now, one step. Let us pull Rwanda. I'm going to pull Rwanda. In real time, I want you guys... So you guys would see. Okay. So Rwanda 2021. Let's compare. 2021 scorecard for Rwanda. Let's compare with Sierra Leone. Rwanda scores 33% in political rights. 33%. You know why? Because they have effective civil societies. If you already hear about the recent case of Rosa Sabagina, the guy where we do Hotel Rwanda. If you guys follow social news, Paul Rosa Sabagina has been arrested, you know, by Paul Kagame. Where, you know, he extradite him, come to Rwanda, they charge him for crimes there because they say it is support a militia in Rwanda recently over the past 10 years or so. So they arrest him. He has been sentenced to 25 years in jail. Paul Rosa Sabagina. I go look for what's in Alashona. But guys, in real time, I'm showing you guys the political right for Rwanda. Can you imagine? Rwanda, we don't left we bien. They go. Rwanda is going. Look at Rwanda. Guys, if I talk here without showing you guys evidences, people would think, say, we want for, you know, come no more and come and discredit, these folks. But that is not what we're doing. I'm showing you guys my screen in real time. Because I want you guys to see what I'm doing. Let me understand, say, I'm not making these things up. I want you guys to understand, I am not making these things up. Let me, now we can compare and contrast. Look, Rwanda, I want to tell you, between Rwanda and Sierra Leone, this is Rwanda. This is Rwanda. Good. Rwanda, 2021. Political rights, 33%. Civil liberties, 25%. So, una look Sierra Leone. Let go to Sierra Leone. Sierra Leone is right here. Go. All right. Let's see. Sierra Leone. Guys, with everything that is happening, this is Sierra Leone. We scored 96% in political rights. And then you guys tell me, I've never seen a video of in Rwanda when a minister, they go and toss a ballot box in the air. Una look at this video. This is a minister of transportation. Look up. Look up. Guys, this is why I took my time to invest in this platform. This is why I took my time to do this, because some of these things, if you come out and just say them, people will be like, where's the evidence? What is he talking about? Because SLPP are good with lies, right? They come with the cyber crime laws and all that nonsense, whatever you want for bring. The same thing way Albert Magai bring in 1965, the criminal libel law, for shut down people, not for speak up about the realities and the truth, right? That is why I invest in this platform. With every application, I had to learn this thing. I'm not an IT professional, but I had to learn this. This is a whole television production area, personaya. Because of these kinds of things, I want you guys to see these things in real time. Look at Sierra Leone, 96%. Look at Rwanda. In political rights, 33%. We only admire Rwanda. We only admire Rwanda. Look, Rwanda, civil liberties. They said a 25% Rwanda score. They failed woefully. Can you imagine? But Rwanda is this beautiful country that is advanced. Where we all want for land, we can't see like Salon, rich Rwanda. But look at the scores where Sierra Leone gets. This for sure say there is a problem. There is a fundamental problem with our civil societies and all of these people that are reporting to these organizations. There is a fundamental issue with deceit. With lies, with untruths them. We're not to depict the reality of what is happening on the ground. I'm showing you videos. Let me show you another video of this SLPP with them thugs them. Where a guy, because within themselves, factionally fighting. I showed you guys a video of them attacking themselves in a Potoru. Chop, chop that guy. The guy survived. But yet they will tell you, say, Ibrahim, let me show you that picture on a Cameroon when this video was circulated all over social media. I call the attention of the government. When I come and address this issue with this video, it is not in Cameroon, even though these people are speaking Creole, not to Cameroon. When I come out and can't debunk this, Usa Yapi, let me know. When I tell people them, that is a responsible government. That is how they behave. But they allow the video for fester around the social media. Hey, they say, Ibrahim, Usa Ibrahim, you go pull video. But these are the things. These are the realities. Let me show now how the guy attacked himself. Well, watch this. And by the way, guys, very abusive language. I'm just going to warn you. Abusive language. If you don't say you're not comfortable with abusive language, just, you know, block your ears. But listen to this. This is SLPP attacking themselves because they get leadership war. For chairman or chairman, so there is this the leader. Una, listen to this.
Don't put a record. Your mama ask for us. If you don't like it, not your child, not your child. Your mama ask. So if you go talk to media, next time, if you pull your mama. You don't say that. You don't record.
Yes.
You don't record it. Your mama be my way, go talk to media.
Yes, sir.
If you do it again next time, would they describe you way your mama can at junior? They would the way you back can at junior. Not do it again next time. No, not slap. Not your child.
You're so bad slapping.
Well, then you go above.
No, then above self. No more, any one born above.
Another work.
No, any one no more born above.
Another work.
No more. Now, your mama no more just come for describe to you.
Yes, sir.
You say mama kaka you. Yes, the guy mama kaka you. No go do that issue then dey.
But
where go am? You dey put your block. Take off for that.
Na nothing.
Not your
chat at talk.
Not your chat.
You na wait. People then dey watch. You na wait.
Not your chat. Next time, if you take your mama again,
yes,
you go in the media.
Yes, sir.
You send an Agba mayor, district council.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. They also know about Kaisamba. They also know about the other council. They send that they go talk about the media. If you catch for describing mama, would they describe your mama? They even know about the describe you back. Like how they describe you. Now wait,
my
before. Another boy, allow me.
Yes, sir.
Allow me, mama, Bombola, describe her. Fine.
Yes, sir.
Fine.
Sabi mama.
I'm glad you were come, sir. If you call me sir, because I'm the now na power.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
Not do issue where people yes. They support you. Do issue where they support you.
Yes, sir.
Never do issue where person dey there. You don't understand? So take him mama now. Take him mama bombo now. Go left there now. Go take him mama now.
Okay.
Go now. Go.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much. Welcome, eh? Go see mama now.
Yes, sir.
So guys, why am I showing you this? This is a political rights issue that is being trampled upon. Why? Because the SLPP is supporting these things. There's this, look this idiot on the page now. Claude Moigua. You see, this is the problem. And you know, we can always say, what can you do with you then? You say, when you look at the people where they come for a can attack we, and these were the same people where they share me audio and me videos then, by the way. Claude Moigua. Now, you can't tell me, say, Ibrahim, APC will never give you a job. Like I ask and say, I want a job. When I was going after the APC at the time, these were the people celebrating me and dancing me. These are the dedicated idiots that I keep talking about. But why they say them dedicated idiots? People they feel say no more making these things up. But these are the issues. These are the people. But let me show now exactly now for corroborate this story. When I listen to this other guy, we come for debunk this thing where this particular SLPP guy do. Because the SF don't see, they no say I get for see that video. And once I see that video, I get for relate them into context. Because everything we do is about context and perspective, right? So I'm going to show you guys this now. When I see when I listen to this guy now, all landed there, when they talk. When I listen
today
to
on this very day, on the 29th of September, 2023, this now on a brother, Musa VB, day on live today. I just want to talk about this particular disturbing video we somebody just sent to me what happened this morning. This young man inside this video, now the organizing secretary, winner Salu Van de Bao, he go for go admit in Peking this morning. As they come out of the gate, they attack him. Very serious attack. Then they talk, say, how they go describe him, mama, whatever he do or anything he do, they know exactly what him for do. And the kind of violence where they move on for do, if that man, they be do anything, maybe they for do attack him, for try for kill him. But this now the handwork of Agbao. This now the handwork of Prince Adin. But now one thing we are the always they tell SLPP.
All right, guys. I want to leave that there. Who is Prince Adin? Prince Adin is the chairman of the SLPP currently. So these guys knows these things. Not to me say this, right? I'm corroborating everything I'm saying. I'm trying to corroborate the story for you guys. Because I want you guys to see that the violence, the violation of the political rights of the people is from the leadership within the SLPP. And then you look at the scorecard of the M.C.C. 2021 fiscal year. It says the SLPP scored 96% in political rights. They did the same thing again in 2020 when we saw what happened to Ibrahim Kamara, Rabo Bowe, Josephine Jackson, the Bitante. Ibrahim Kamara, Josephine Jackson, remember Rabo Bowe? Constituency 110 election. Then broke the election box. That election was held 3 times. Then you tell me, say this government, they passed political rights, then they passed civil liberties. We're enshrined in the democratic rights of the people. Guys, as Sierra Leoneans, we ought to be ashamed of ourselves. We ought to be ashamed of ourselves. But these are the people. These are the issues that we're talking about. And this is why I come to you guys. Let me remind you, Lona Ibrahim Kamara. Lona Yerin's story. What happened to Ibrahim Kamara when his civil liberties were violated by Josephine Jackson? Now, constituency, one time election. The very first time we went for older elections. This is Ibrahim. Now, the Bobo, this way, Josephine Jackson. Peter. Bitante, violating right. Who is Josephine Jackson? So these are the things we want to show you guys. So you guys would see exactly what we're talking about. And this will remind me, I'll forget to fold on Ibrahim. La Fen in video then, by the way. I need that video there of Ibrahim. When Josephine Jackson then punished that about Bitante. I need that video there. I hope you don't get me archiving system where that video will be there around. But these are the things I want to share with you guys. Look at Sierra Leone and look at Rwanda. Rwanda, where we all admire, beautiful Rwanda, they score 33% in political rights. Can you imagine? But Sierra Leone scored 96%. Ebo, for everything that is happening. But yet, this president, they go in a tweet. When I look in Twitter page, the tweets, they talk about MCC. Look at it. Look at him there. These are the issues that are bothering us. You look at all of this violence. This man has never condemned violence in Sierra Leone. Has never condemned violence. Why? Because they thrive on violence. Look at the snap with the M.C.C. This is the whole team. This is the staff now, Washington, D.C. But look at them. This is the M.C.C., folks. But look at all the videos I've shown you guys. Look at all, everything I've shown you. These are the realities that I want you guys to learn. I want to say, and when we learn this, the result of us having a rebel war was because people will not be getting an avenue for bring out these things and speak up about these things. So that was why they're going to bush. Ali Kaba, Charles Taylor said, Ali Kaba going to bush, you go bring rebel war, kill with people. Then. Ali Kaba is free. Why? Because we not talk. Sierra Leoneans, we sit down. But now you make me advocacy, make them pull Ali Kaba to the United Nations. Because after they find out, say, this man, they do all anything they are, go after. You don't deserve for the United Nations. You are a warlord. You are a rebel leader. You should not be in the United Nations. Then pull and they. Look at the MCC scorecard. How is Sierra Leone scoring more than Rwanda? Rwanda, the beautiful country you all they admire. Rwanda, where Paul Kagame don't make delegate today. Look at that. We run a quiet and peaceful so. Then go tell you say, but we're in deep politics. Look at Rwanda. Look at Rwanda. Let me show. Whilst I talk now, I can put a video. Let it roll through. You don't want to see what I talk about. But guys, this is why I do what I do. Because it's about education. It's about sensitization and ensuring that we not get no vacuum anymore with information in this 21st century. Sierra Leone is going to move forward. 60-70% of the wealth of Africa, and Sierra Leone is a classic example, is outside in the international community. It is outside now America, Europe, Dubai, these places. That is why these guys are stashing their money in illicit banking accounts across the country. Look at Rwanda. Let me play this. Let this video they play whilst I'm doing at a talk to owner. Look at Rwanda. As peaceful as Rwanda is. Look at Rwanda. Look at the housing. Look at Rwanda. Look where Paul Kagame to make Rwanda. How on earth Rwanda scores 33% in political rights, but Sierra Leone is scoring 96%. Guys, I want us to ponder on these things. Look at Rwanda. One of the cleanest country in Africa. But the MCC report says that Sierra Leone scored 96% amidst this level of violence that we've shown you guys. I miss this level of violence. We've all seen it again today in Sierra Leone. Today, we've seen it in Sierra Leone again. Look at Rwanda. I'm not making these things up. This is not Rwanda, beautiful Rwanda. How Sierra Leone, they score better than political rights and civil liberties. Rwanda not score that much. Since SLPP came to power, they've done nothing absolutely to change the lives of the people. Usa APC stop, former President Kuruma stop, Nadei stop. This is Rwanda, guys. I'm not making these things up. Out of this country, look, the roads are so good, they have inspired a skating culture among youths. Look, beautiful Rwanda. Rwanda, they score 33% in political rights. That means these people are doing their jobs. Their civil societies are doing their jobs. Look at it. Look at the president. Look at him. Look at the housing structure of Rwanda. Huh? Rwanda scored 33% in political rights. Sierra Leone scored 96%. Amidst this political intimidation, arresting of opposition, locking up people like the cameramans, is in jail, denied due process. And you are telling me that Sierra Leone scored 96% in political rights and civil liberties? Sierra Leone is our country. But we cannot allow these guys. Look at the transportation system, Rwanda. Look at this, Rwanda. How on earth did we get here? Look at this. Paul Kagame, look at the president. Working with the community. a failed political right? Paul Kagame failed? Is that what you guys are telling me? Huh? Look at Sierra Leone. Look at the M.C.C. report. Look at the M.C.C. report, Sierra Leone. 96% right here. 96%. Well, let me show now. Let me shock you with something. Look at Rwanda when it comes to control of corruption. When I see Rwanda, control of corruption, 100%. And we know say this is not made up. This is not fakery because we are seeing the improvement in the lives of the people. Look at Sierra Leone. 81%. When we have a first lady who is a criminal and a thief. Unaluka, 81% in the fight against corruption. We have a first lady. African Express has reported and reported and reported. Look at these guys. Fatima Bio received money from the Consolidated Fund. She lied about it. She said no, she never received any money. Only for the African Express to come out and point out these things. She lied to us. But why? Because she's a Gambian. So you don't really care. Oh, you know what, guys? I was waiting for a shipment.
How about you? You
I'm a Gambian. And
guys, of course, I'll be right back.
Fatima Jabi, and I'm an actress.
I'll be right back, okay? And, let me just go to this screen here. I'll be right back, guys. I was waiting for a shipment. Hold on.